people, Team Komatsu. Oh, I'm loving the Komatsu. Boy, I might see a 170, Komatsu 170 in my future to complete the fleet, you know what I mean? This WA-270-7, 2014, 3,400 hours. Tight, tight, tight. Come from it came from a town out of Massachusetts. It was a town machine. They traded it in at the dealer, and I picked it up. But you know, it had its fair share of salt damage on the bucket and where they normally have it, and I had to get everything sandblasted down, and it's all good now. I mean, there's some scaling and stuff, but kid that sandblasted it did a really good job. If anybody's looking locally that needs some sandblasting, he's mobile, he's got a dustless sander, I could hook you up. Hit me up with the you can either email me or hit me up in the comments, I'll give you his contact info. But yeah, this thing is just nice. I gotta load out a lot of trucks. This is the solar farm that I've been on, over half a mile of trench in, 2,000 foot of backfill of sand, compacted it lifts, so everything's good. I mean, check this out, it's so quiet in here, cozy, just like the D51, and everything's working out in that aspect. A lot of technology in this thing, it's real sweet. So this is going to be a transformer pan. All of our trenches led to this, and all the pipes in the ground, we got tape over all this to cap them so I don't get rocks inside there, and I gotta go up through the blue line. I doubt you guys can see that, but just get it close, and then I'll hit it off with the other machine. Very, very tight site. That's why I really didn't film, and there was a lot going on. You know, in and out of all these poles. Dump this whole load right there. I'll shovel that out. But let me show you the site real quick. All in front there, in front of there is all trench done. And then this goes all the way back as far as the tree line is. That's where I am working today. I got another pad like this that I just put in. But all this dirt has to come out. There's like probably, I don't know, 75 trucks or so. I got three trucks running for 3 days to get rid of the site. All this dirt, it's good gravel. So guy's gonna repurpose, a buddy of mine that we actually do have another project on coming up. It's gonna be an exciting one too. But yeah, we gotta trench in that, all these poles, and then they put the purlins on the top of them. But yeah, it's a good job. It was a takeover basically. They needed help on it, and I came in to help out. Basically, I'm gonna take this windrow piles and just pile it all up in one spot, so that I'll have it ready for these truckers coming, so I can load it out. I mean, we got so much rain. I got four sites going, and a lot of washouts, to tell you, but it is what it is. I'm starting another driveway, which right down the road from here, which I was gonna grab some of this gravel and save it, because I gotta bring in like 30 trucks, so this would be really good in the spots I have to go 2 foot thick over the culverts and stuff, because it's really bony and it will bind up. Hey now! Just getting used to the loader, you know. I ran loader here or there, but never owned one. I got to obviously the backhoe. Same scenario. It's the same thing as basically a big skid steer, but it's got more technology as far as like where the bucket is positioned. It's got sensors all in it. It's got ride control. It's got everything you would want. Let's just put it that way. But this is what I'll be doing for the next 3 days, moving dirt, piling it, and loading at the same time in between trucks. They're trucking probably an hour away anyways where all this is going. But you know, 45 minutes or so, and it'll give me time to get everything out from where it is. I got piles over to the right that gotta come out. I got the Busa here for all the tight spots. Now all this trenching that we're cleaning up now, I didn't trench this part. I just backfilled it, which the trench is over to the left. Cause you know if I trench it, that spoil pile will be dead straight. Wouldn't look like a snake. So when you take over a project, there was piles everywhere where there shouldn't have been piles, you know, as far as how I would do it. I mean, everybody excavates different, but I've moved the same dirt here probably four different times, and it drives me nuts, because if you could just move it once or twice, that's the goal, you know. But every site's different. When they're tight and you got a bunch of guys following you between the, to lay conduit, you gotta blow in the trench real fast, so you don't really have time to load it out either. Boy, she eats. This thing's got a creeper mode in it, which it's a snail mode. I'll show you guys all that when we got time to go over this thing. I really just learned it myself too. But I've been looking at loaders for a while, especially in the commercial world. Like after I did all these, I realized I needed a loader. It's got the quick connect front so I could put forks or a grapple and all that on it. But I knew, you know, I was using the backhoe and that worked great at all these. But, you know, when you move stone and have to move stuff all the way across site, skid steer is not ideal. Too bouncy and it's just not fast, and the wear and tear on it, you know, not just the wear and tear on the tracks aren't good. So, oh yeah, get it, boy. So the name of this, my son named this Big Boy. That's the name of, or not Big Boy, Big Boss. It's called Big Boss. So that's how we'll be referring it. She does dry out quick though, these piles. That's why it's good material. You know, it will get wet, but she dries out quick. Oh yeah, she's a beast. Growing on me now. She's growing on me. It's starting to dry out, so it's a little more, it's better, you know what I mean? It's like, the thing was just sliding and now you're going into these wet, big piles of gravel. It doesn't, one push through them, you just want to spin, you know, earlier. But a little bit of, it's still wet, a little bit of tackiness goes a long way. So we're just cutting this windrow out. And, oh yeah. There's three settings on here too, so you don't spin the tires as much. There's a max, an auto, and a slippery. Probably in mud or snow or one of the two, but looks like I'm gonna have to get an Arctic pusher for this thing on the quick connect. That'll be nice and nice. A lot easier than pushing with a bucket, you know, but we'll see. We will see. Right now I don't have ride control on because trying to push the dirt with ride control, I've noticed seems a little more different. So watch when I put ride control on there, little icon comes on the dash, and then this bucket actually, see, go up and down. It's going up and down by itself, so it doesn't yank you. So the bucket will go and it will do it before it senses the bumps. Pretty cool. It's a wicked smooth ride when that thing's on. Hey, I got this windrow all piled up. Got a little bit in the front to do. I'll get all this in between the trucks tomorrow. It's supposed to be 80 degrees, so once this back blade. Once this sets up with the sun, I'll have a lot more. Hey, get that rock out of there. Hang on. Gotta get that rock out. Once this sets up tomorrow, I'll have a lot more traction. One more pass in the center and we'll call this done did. That's all we do is rough grade here. There's gonna be a crew coming in after us and polish a place, polishing up, I guess. I don't know. But that's it. I tell you, once you have a loader, you say, why didn't I have one years? For years. I'll be using this more than I expected to. Use it as a skid steer. I mean, obviously you gotta have a big sight and all that. You're not gonna bring it to a homeowner special, you know? Back on site bright and early. Got here at 5 a.m. The crew's just rolling in now. It's probably 7. I've been stockpiling dirt. I got 3 trucks running all day today. So it's the loadout, the last phase of this project. For me, just a quick cleanup, slick off, and that's it, you know? Just taking the right corner of the blade so I'm not spreading it so much. A little less slippery today, you know? This stuff dries out pretty good. What gear am I in here? Going too fast. Went the wrong way with it. You wanna be in first, I was in third. Yeah. So this is it, just waiting on the trucks. That's why I am stockpiling. And that's what I'll do in between the trucks is stockpile throughout the day. There's piles all in the back right side and all that have to still come out. I could do it with the off-road truck loading up, load them up and out. I got you in a different position on the camera this morning. Give you the bird's eye view instead of the cab view. Get you right up close to the window. Probably could hear me better too because the camera's near my face. Checked all the fluids this morning, greased her down, drained the water separator, filled her up with some diesel. Like I said yesterday, never had a loader before besides the backhoe and a skid steer, which some people call that a loader, but it's not. And always wanted one, and I might keep the backhoe. I don't know, you know what I mean? I had it for sale. I had a bunch of people wanting it, but again, I couldn't replace it. Until I replaced it with this, I wasn't gonna get rid of it because you never know when you need it. In commercial sites, you need it. No doubt you need either a loader or a backhoe, something to move stone fast or dirt across the lot. And this thing will be pushing some serious snow. All right, here's my first truck coming in, and we're gonna go to the back of this lot and load out the worst of the materials first. This is all more gravelly up in the front. This has changed. This material has changed quite a bit throughout the lot here. We got sand, we got gravel, we got even parts that are a little more clay, actually. But overall, it's good stuff. Alrighty, on the first bucket here, I gotta get a better setup here so we can load this out better. I don't like the out of levelness I am right now. Get this load in slow form here. Man, this truck's got low sides, nothing like my truck. My truck's way higher than that. But I got a wicked dip in the way I'm going over right now, and it's uncomfortable for the loader just to be rocking. It's not ideal, so we want to fix that. Like right here. Right down and up. We got six trucks here. Holy lordy, I'm gonna be busy, boy. Good. Gotta get a better setup though, so I can be faster on my cycle times. Bear with me, I'm not used to loading. This is my first time loading with this guy. But big boss, get this loaded up and we'll get in a better position. Driver, it's a 56 minute run, so that's a 2 hour window to come back. That stinks. I don't know. We'll see what this does. I gotta get a better setup here. Driver, we got you situated now. Got a little better setup here, and these six buckets makes these trucks happy, so that's about 18 yards. There you go. So we'll try to get six buckets, two in this side. She's heavy. The other stuff up front isn't as heavy. This, if we didn't have all that rain, it wouldn't be as sticky either, you know, but nothing you can do about it. Get it off my sight, that's all I care about. 5 trucks, all loaded up. They'll spread them out so I'm not so sitting alone all day. Oh yeah, it's a better setup now. Coming back, turn on the other way. You gotta square up. Yeah, square up. Now back, yeah. Not that square. Round everybody gets confused, but the worst part is we'll be changing spots everywhere here because we're going to be out of this pile pretty soon. Finally getting traction, pile's drying up. I think this is the 6th truck. We got 7 running, 2 hour round trip, like I said. No easy way to get to the site either. Driver said it's gonna go all different roads. But I put some stone down. That's what's giving me some track. I put some stone down to dry up the slop. And that gives me some love on the tires. And then you can get into here and just grab a full bucket, you know? But I'll have to burn the tires off. small scoop. That will do her. Still making the journey, cutting windrows, stacking them up 80 degrees so the piles are drying a little bit. It's a little better loading as far as traction on the ground. We already got rid of all the other piles down there and we're under this pile now. I got a little down in the bottom of those, down in that gut, which I'll wait till it's dry to transfer that up. But yeah, it's hauling out. I think I got 6 trucks going. We were gonna have 7, but looks like 6 for today. Tomorrow, if we get the rest of this pile out today, each driver I think is gonna do 4 rounds. That'll give me 24 loads out of here. Cause it's a 2-hour trip, you know, an hour there, an hour back. One driver just came now and just said he found a quicker rate and he was back, and the other guys aren't here yet, so he did definitely find a quicker way. This is I don't know. No lunch, bored in my loader. Just me and my loader, and YouTube. Well, let's unload this bucket. We got something exciting to show anyways. He's gonna pull him out. Let's see what happens here. Yeah. We're gonna have to get a strap. We got a truck off and he's ready to tip it and flip it. He's gonna flip it. I don't have, hopefully this thing will pull him out. I gotta get a chain. I'm gonna put it in creeper mode. Guess not. Ain't even, are you going? Well, that was eventful, but he's still stuck. Boss man says don't touch the truck, don't go near it. Get pictures and he'll assess it. These guys are friends of mine that own this company. So we want to take special care of it. We don't want to tear nothing up. We definitely don't want to flip it. Can't dump the load off. It's way too much of it out of an angle. Figured the loader out a little bit better and put it in slippery mode. I don't know why it was, you know, no brainer. Put it in slippery mode, Mike. And it won't spin as much. It's like a limited slip, you know, or limited power or whatever it does to the wheels. Lets you get the bucket better. But this is wet stuff still, and the guy said it's really heavy on the truck. It's coming out in one shot, like a sheet. You get the box up 3/4 away, then all of a sudden, ba-boom, she comes ripping out. Because, you know, an hour ride, she starts molding to the box like Jell-O cup. Loading out of V, that's your best production anyways. Tension on there. Well, I'm standing up, but we got them. We got them. Got the first truck loading out. Got this all stockpiled up. It's drier stuff, better stuff, and I'm on Stone Road to load out, so it should be a comfortable day of loading, but it's raining, so that really stinks. But we got all that dirt out in the back side of the property yesterday, so hopefully this front will be gone, and then I got one more day of these guys hauling, then some miscellaneous stuff that I'll haul off myself, probably a couple farmers coming in and hauling off with their trucks. It'll all work out. I wish we had better weather, but it is what it is, man. Everybody's dealing with this stuff around here. Seems like it's either super dry and hot or wicked wet. Can't get no happy. Eight trucks lined up now. Ooh, this pile's gonna disappear fast. Sometimes truck drivers just can't follow the other truck driver. Everybody's gotta get different directions to how to back up to the pile. One guy goes behind me, one guy goes in front of me. I was loading the trucks over too far. This loader reaches farther than I think, so when they pull away, I can see I was over to the left, which would be my far side away with the material. With an excavator, you know, you can judge it with the bucket right down the center of the truck, but now I know to not roll so much forward. Learning, boys, learning on the loader. With the Komatsu WA-270. I'm gonna start dumping here now and then roll forward. Just checking back in. This is the eighth truck of the morning. We got some downpouring rain coming right now, and it's supposed to let up, but the loader's so much more comfortable today because I'm on solid ground and I'm not fighting it and spinning the tires and getting half buckets. And that was frustrating yesterday. It made me want to get out of this thing quick. So now it's actually like a set up like a quarry, you know what I mean? I got all my piles roached, all ready to go, so they're all fluffed and nice, so you can dig into them easy. The way it should be. I mean, the rain, the other ones were like that too, but the rain got into them and then it dried, then the rain got into them again and then turned to like concrete. Couldn't work it. Once that happens, it's almost like virgin ground again. All right, last last bucket for the morning rush. Now they'll be half hour before the first truck gets back, probably. When they all come together in the morning, it is hectic. It ain't hectic, it's just you gotta get it done. Now I'll take my piles over here and bring them over there, just so I don't keep pushing them into our transformer pad. Get them roached up, ready to go to load out. Keep everything clean so I can stay on the stone. And that's that. That's how you know it, or that's how I do it. Well, this pile is almost gone. It's been wet. We've been getting hammered with rain, just like sprinkle dinkle all day. I got the window down, so it's probably loud right now, but it's been sprinkling all day. So I'm losing traction, and I'm into the cut where the utility cut, so there's sand there, and I, you know, wants a bounce of chalk and all that, so I'm trying to reposition myself. Reposition myself here. On to the next pile. We're doing good, man. They're getting, we'll have in 3 days, we'll have all this dirt out. I still got to get dirt all in back of those solar panels. It's really more skid steer work because it's so tight. This loader's too big to get in there, but I got to get it transferred out. Big pile, then I'm gonna have to consolidate another pile. I probably got enough dirt to make one more big pile. Got the farm truck back. He's been hauling more than the trucking company because he's right around the corner. So his turnaround times are fast. The other guys, like I said, are 2 hours. But there's 8 trucks running today, so when they show up, they take a chunk. There ain't no doubt. But at that hourly rate, you know, running 8 trucks, you're over $1,100 an hour to get it off site. 10-hour days, you're well over 10 G's. Give them one more scoop for the Borgesville farm. Right here in town, he's actually, land is bordering this solar farm. That silt fence is his land right on it. And he watches the channel for 3 years now. That's pretty good. He didn't know this was me over here working. Another fleet. I sent one truck home early because we didn't have enough material for him. So now I've been consolidating more because the rain has stopped. Come on, buddy. Now you're into my pile, but whatever. Whatever, driver. Had to make it work. Sun came out, so I've got the whole front just about to this pile. I got one more day of just consolidating some miscellaneous, and I don't need as many trucks for that day, that's for sure. So that won't be bad, 2.5 days to get all this dirt off here. There's 2,000 tons, at least 2,000 tons. Well, it's probably more than that. I brought in 2,000 tons of sand, and this stuff's a lot heavier than sand. I'd say there's 3,000 tons then. And with it being wet, can't put as much on the trucks. So, you know, I know. Maybe I don't. I don't know. got the backup camera. Well, I'll tell you what, I loaded out 40 trucks, 800 ton, and I filled up this morning. Look at that gauge on that gas. There. Didn't even blink an eye. That's crazy. Just giving it the old black drag, slick, slop, sloopy, doopy, doo-doo. Knocking the hides down just so it dries up and then you fluff it up. This whole place gets graded out. Not by me, but a crew comes in here and grades this whole place, so. One last truck here for the day. Farm truck, Miller Farms out of Voorheesville, New York. Small little town we're in. It's good to get the locals in. Other spot that will be doing. Alright guys, we'll catch you on the next one. We'll get this uploaded. Hopefully you love this Komatsu as much as I do. Team Komatsu got three pieces, and the Hydrema also is my dealer support. Same exact dealer deals with those, so I'm pretty good right now. If I do get another Komatsu, it might be a 170 if I can find a screaming deal on it, you know. On site, my butt's all toasty, my back's all toasty. I'm like, what's going on here? My heated seat was on. I was cleaning inside the loader. I got this pile, last pile all done, probably 10-15 triaxles, but I got farm truck coming, so it might be a little more. We'll haul this. It's 3 o'clock. I just came here. I was actually knocking in the driveway, so we'll haul this out today, the rest of the day, and then tomorrow half day should have it all done. Then I'm done with the site. We're out of here. Got to do the driveway. So yeah, let's get to it. Oh yeah. You don't have to tell farm truck how to back in. He gets it. I'll tell you, it's dry and nice, and the material is nice. It's not gonna stick to the bucket. First time since I had the loader, because all the days I loaded out here, it was wet, mucky, slippery. So today is the day that I can actually experience the loader in the ultimate conditions. Going to the truck and it doesn't rock. It just makes everything faster and nicer. You don't have to throttle out. Back on site early Saturday morning. Got to get this stuff out of here. It's nice and dry. It's been windy and nice. Farm truck's hauling the rest out. We tried getting the drone in the air this morning, but haven't flown the drone in a long time, and I don't know, the cables keep losing connection to the controller. I almost lost it the last time I used it, and I forgot to order the stuff, so gotta get back on that. This would have been a nice drone footage of loading this out and showing you the field, but couldn't do it. Sorry, guys. I gotta order that. I'm looking on eBay now or on Amazon. I can't find that stuff. Is what it is. Last time I flew it, I lost it in the dark. I lost controller, so now I'm flying in the dark trying to find my way back. And it was at night, so I could hear. I couldn't hear it. It was far away. And then I called my neighbor, and he said he saw a blinking light, but I didn't know if I was going in the right direction. So I just started. I just said, I'm sending it. It's just gonna crash. And I could hear it, and then I end up seeing the light and bringing it back, you know. But craziness. It will come to home when the battery is ready to completely go to put, supposedly, but I haven't done that yet. Material is real nice now. It's like perfect consistency for packing and everything else. Finally, it's been a fight on this job with all that stuff. Thank you.
aisles disappearing. Here's a question for you guys. So this comes loaded. Normal editions don't come with the full fender. It just comes with the half fender. So this is a special, when you order it, you know what I mean? That's why it's a Town Machine. It has every option. They don't skimp out. But I'm thinking about taking these fenders off because I got to get these panels repainted over the winter. These, I got some bubbling going on here. So I'm going to get those panels. Do you guys like these fenders on there or have open fenders? I'm not sure. I don't know what would look better. Let me know. I feel like the fenders, you know what I mean, hold everything in there and make everything splashy. I don't know. But those two panels got to get redone.